first and last words I want to hear out of your stinking holes is, sir, do I make myself clear?
Sir, yes, sir!
My goal is simple. As of right now, you are all maggots. You will not speak until spoken to. You will not sleep unless told to do so. When I ask you to jump, you will reply with, how high? Do you get me?
Sir, yes, sir!
What's your name, dirtbag? Sound off like you got a pair! Corporal Shepherd, huh? Looks more like Corporal Dog Meat to me. Seems your name was mysteriously bumped to the top of the advanced training list. My suggestion to you is to get your ass down to the training center and report to Drill Instructor Sharp ASAP. Now move it, Corporal. Where are you from, soldier? Texas? Holy cow! You know what comes from Texas, don't you? You eyeballing me, boy? You had better square yourself away, maggot! I smell smoke, and where there's smoke, there's fire! You better move it, soldier!
Okay. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Opposing Force. This is the boot camp. This is their version of the Hauser course. And I don't know if I'll keep the intro that I already have, but if I don't, and I probably won't, this is a lot more, there's a lot more put into this, it feels, in some cases, than the original Hauser course. But remember, it's the whole idea of Black Mesa versus the military. So, we just have to figure out where we're going, which I'm assuming is just going to be the exit. Yes. This expansion pack is much larger than Blue Shift. It's probably longer than Blue Shift by about 2 hours, approximately. And, yeah, there's just a lot put into it.
One, two, three, four. You call that a push-up? All the way down! What is your major...
Also, this is based off of this whole, the intro course and the drill instructors are based off a military film. I forget which one. But yeah, let's get into it, right? It's taking long enough. This seems like the game has a lot more maps because, fuck. Yeah, the game seems like it has a lot more maps than Half-Life 1 and 2, at least in the intro sequence.
This is a restricted area, soldier.
Okay.
I'm sorry, Corporal, this is a restricted area.
But in the, in Opposing Force, you play as Corporal Shepherd. In Blue Shift, you play as Barney, a security guard. And then in Half-Life, you play as Gordon. All of these people make an appearance in Half-Life 2, except for Shepard. Same with Gina Cross, like, and Colette Green. Like, both those two do not make an appearance. Yeah, but I guess that's how it is, right?
Listen up! I don't care what your previous outfit was like, but around here we do things my way! Follow my instructions carefully, and by the end of the day I'll have you eating danger and cropping victory! Now move your butt, soldier! I will meet you on the other side in the armory!
Okay. Can't go back, okay. Okay, welcome to the armory.
Mounted on the wall below me, you will see a PCB. This is a powered combat vest. Use it correctly and I guarantee it will save your life. Your PCB is able to recharge from battery power, or it can
interface and recharge with commercial, military, and HEV charging stations. What are you waiting for? Grab that PCB and get it fully charged. Trust me, Maggot, you're gonna need it. I'll meet you in the next area to demonstrate some of your best capabilities.
Unlike Barney, who has armor that can't power back up, Shepard and Freeman both have armor you can just power up. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. I do have to note, though, that I took, like, 5 health in damage, so... Oops.
You're going to have to pick up the pace, dirtbag! My beloved Core does not have the patience to wait around for your worthless butt! The following areas will simulate many of the environmental hazards you are likely to encounter in the field. Run through it as quickly as you can and try to avoid taking too much damage. A dead Marine is a worthless Marine. I will
sir,
see you up ahead if you can make it through alive.
Sir, yes, sir. Sore? Sir, yes, sir. I do have to note, though, something that they don't say.
What's that on your vest, soldier? Did that sting a little? Well, suck it up and drive on. I'm not through with you yet. Proceed through that door into the small staging room and await my instructions.
Okay. Somebody asked you to note that this is...
smoke, and where there's smoke, there's fire. You better move it, soldier.
Okay. Somebody should note is that this is only a vest. Oh, my eyes. Flashbang. Okay.
Well, I'll be damned. You may just have what it takes to be a soldier. Now double time it over to the next portion of your training.
Sir, yes, sir. So I feel like this is quite creative. It's fun, too.
Move it! Move it! All right, Maggot. Let's see if you can move your butt through my obstacle course. On your mark. Get set. Go, go, go! Run up and over those platforms. Move, move, move! Duck, now jump! Get your sorry ass moving! Get your ass down that hill! Scale that wall! Hurry it up! My dear sweet grandmother moves faster than you, dirtbag! Get over that beam! I thought we were training soldiers here! Are you trying to embarrass me? Proceed to the next area! Come on, double time it! Move, move, move!
This turned from being fun to very demeaning.
Let's see if you can climb faster than you can run! Ready? Maybe there's hope for you yet. Now, want to come up here and try to knock me off? You can definitely climb better than you can run. Now let's see if you can use these ropes for more than just simple climbing.
Ladders. Ladders in Half-Life are not very good.
Jump, catch that rope, and use your momentum to swing across that water. This might take more coordination than you have, soldier. I want you to swing from rope to rope and meet me at the end of the course. problem, soldier. Try it again.
This mechanic, it sucks. Like, really bad. Back and forth.
What is your problem, soldier? Get back up and try it again.
There we go. You go up and down the ladders. Ropes. Woo.
I'm almost impressed, soldier. Meet me in the next section and let's see if I can shake you up a bit.
I don't like those ropes as a mechanic. Hopefully we don't see them too much. I'm really hoping.
You better move like you got a purpose.
Live fire test range.
This is a live fire exercise. This one will give you a taste of what it's like to be in the field. Keep your head low and move between cover. I want to see your face in the dirt, soldier.
Let's go.
Go, go, go! Climb that rope ladder. Get your ass up there. Hit the dirt, soldier. Move it. Move it. Move it. Training exercise in one. Very good, soldier. Move on for your next phase of training.
Just thinking about it, I think that exercise would also kill people if they weren't a almost immortal respawning game character. Unless you're using rubber bullets. But those actually did real damage, so. Huh.
Sidearm. Pick it up and step over to the pistol range. The object of this exercise is to familiarize yourself with the functions and use of your weapon. The goal is for you to place 6 shots within the inner circle of each target. You may begin.
Okay, I want to be honest. This is the gun that Pickle and I work. We in Crystal Mission, we were like, oh, we need that gun. Well, we got the Magnum later, or in a different location. But this gun shoots Magnum ammo, I believe. Yeah, 357. So. Oh. 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You may proceed to the next section of the training course.
Pistol range. So, is there other gun ranges? Deposit firearms before proceeding with all the guns behind you. Yes, sir, Mr. Quartermaster. Ooh. 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 Sniper.
This exercise will train you in the use of a long-range sniper rifle. Proceed to the table, pick up the sniper rifle, and position yourself on the firing line. In this exercise, you will be firing at targets both moving and stationary at medium, long, and extreme ranges. As you will notice, your sniper rifle comes equipped with a scope. Use this scope to magnify your view, making the distant targets easier to see.
Okay.
In the distance, you will notice 3 stationary targets partially concealed. Hit each of these targets to advance to the next stage of targets. See how you do with simple moving targets at that range, soldier.
I didn't shoot. It ate my input.
Very good. Now let's see if you can hit the moving targets at long range.
Make sure to take your time and light up those shots, soldier. Make sure to take careful aim, soldier. Patience is key for those crucial shots.
I hit that one and it didn't register. Wait.
Not bad, not bad at all, soldier. Now let's see if you can do the same at extreme range.
Extreme!
Unbelievable! You can actually shoot! I'd actually consider letting you cover my ass in a firefight! I've finished with you, soldier. Proceed to the next area and report to the next drill instructor.
Yes, sir. But I do have to note, as with proper firearm safety, yes, sir. Making sure not to aim the gun at you, and bang. I did not think that. I did not think that through, did I?
Exercise will train you in the use of a long-range sniper rifle. Proceed to the table, pick up the sniper rifle, and position yourself on the
between the eyes.
In this exercise, you will be firing at targets both moving and stationary at medium, long, and extreme ranges. As you will notice, your sniper rifle comes equipped with a scope. Use this scope to magnify your view, making the distant targets easier to see. In the distance, you will notice three stationary targets partially concealed. Hit each of these targets to advance to the next stage of targets. Good! Now let's see how you do with simple moving targets at that range, soldier.
Okay, I'm gonna be honest.
See if you can hit the moving targets at long range. Sure to take your time and line up those shots, soldier.
I didn't expect it to get me a court-martial.
Make sure to take careful aim, soldier.
Okay, I hit.
Is key for those crucial shots.
Yeah, and I hit one, and it ate my. It just ate it. It likes to shoot them in the dirt, or it likes to eat them. So.
Not bad, not bad at all, soldier. Christ. Now let's see if you can do the same at extreme range. Unbelievable.
The animation.
I'd actually consider letting you cover my ass in a firefight. I'm finished with you, soldier. Proceed to the next area and report to the next drill instructor.
And there are points where, when I was shooting, the animation wasn't finished, so it wouldn't let me shoot. So it just ate my input.
There you go. Corporal.
Squad training.
All right, dirtbag, you've proven yourself a capable grunt. Now let's see if there's any leadership qualities in that sorry carcass of yours. To become an effective leader, you must familiarize yourself with the skill set of each soldier in your platoon. The first type of soldier you will meet is the engineer. Engineers have a knack for getting you in and out of places that are otherwise inaccessible. Take charge and have him follow you to the sealed door.
Engineers or Angiqueer?
Yes, sir.
Come to the door.
Stand back, Corporal. This should only take a minute.
Yeah. That's what they said when I was playing Blue Shift. But then I killed them all with one single grenade. So, actually, I did a few times. But, so watch that, or rather, watch it overall. Also, that's going to cost quite a bit to reinstall those doors, isn't it?
As you can see, this soldier may prove quite useful in the field. Once you've breached the room, proceed through the door and meet the next type of soldier. Yes, sir. The medic can be one of the most valued soldiers on the field.
Affirmative, sir.
They have the ability to... to heal both you and your fellow squad members. To receive medical attention, simply hold down your use key and the medic will apply first aid. Once the medic has attended to your wounds, proceed to the next area to complete your training.
Affirmative, sir.
Okay.
Listen up, soldier. During the course of your missions, you may not be in direct contact with your squad. In these situations, you will need to utilize any available military radios. These radios can be used to call in reinforcements or gain vital military intelligence. Approach the radio and use it, soldier!
I want to be honest, his voice is very staticky. Also,
I hear you loud and clear. We'll move to your position.
Also, when I was playing Half-Life, I destroyed a lot of these radios, so...
Congratulations, soldier! You're no longer a low-life maggot! I'm proud to say you are a soldier! I'm sure you'll be a credit to your unit! Now report to duty, soldier!
Sir, yes, sir. That should be it, right? Yeah. And that was Half-Life Boot Camp. Is it good? Eh. There's certain parts of it that are eh, but it matches up to the hazard course. So we'll see what happens in the future with it. People recreating this in Black Mesa if someone makes an opposing force mod. And that's pretty much it, I guess. Thank you for watching, and I guess I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.